So today we'll talk about the sequential circuits. So till now we have talked about a variety of combinational circuits where we have an output that is based on the input combination. The impact of current output was not in the, you can say, in the next output. But there are many variety of operations where next output is depend upon the current input. So let's talk about those things. So we required a new variety of circuit. Why we required? So first of all, like whatever circuits we have seen till now, these all are the combinational logic circuits. They are combination of the inputs, like a different combination of the input. The output is not involved in the, like in the next output, but there can be many cases. For example, we already seen one example actually in the previous lectures when we talk about the MUX. Suppose we have this situation, right? Now, in this situation, suppose we want to perform this addition. Now, can we do this addition with only based on the inputs? No. If you have input A, B, and C, and here you have output Y, you require this output to compute the second addition. Means you have to use the next output, or you can say the summation output, to perform the next addition. Means ultimately this output we have to store something, right? Then only you can pass it and then utilize the same adder and perform some operation, right? So this is one example. Similarly, if you say counting, let me say we are talking about counting. And when we count, we always look for the previous number. Let me say I am counting of jump of 2. So 0, then 2, then 4, then 6. What will be the next number?
8.
8. So now how 8 comes into the picture? How you calculated 8? We calculated because we know we have jump of 2 and we aware about what was the previous number. The previous number was 6, so we have added plus 2 and we got the next number. Similarly, in order to get the next number, we need this number to compute the next number, right? So in those kind of circuits, we need to store the current value, and then that stored value will be utilized, and then that will help us to find out the next value. So it means in the circuit diagram, or you can say in the digital system, we should have some system or some method to store the value. But ultimately, what we had in hand, that is the gates only, right? So with the help of gates, we will try to store something. Now, when we say storing, what exactly meaning of storing? Suppose I have a storage device, and if I stored it one, then I went away for a walk, right? Once I came back, then I check what is the value here. What if we are able to retrieve one back, it means you are able to store value. Suppose in another place we have stored zero, and then we go for some walk or eating something, right? Then we come back. After that, we check what value is currently this particular place is holding, or this particular value is holding. If it is holding the same value, means you are able to retrieve it back, right? So that is known as the storage. For example, if you have stored a song, right, somewhere, and if you are able to retrieve that song back, means that is the storage device. Okay, so now today we will see how we'll able to store one bit of the information. If you are able to store the one bit of the information, then you can store n number of bits of the information. Just you have to repeat that circuit into multiple times. So let's look into that circuit, how we can say we are able to store one bit of information, right? So here we require the storing in case of sequential circuit. We have combinational circuit, this will store the output, and that output will feed back to give the next output, and so on. So we have first storage device, that is the SR latch, right? Okay, before this latch, one more thing. Suppose you have a circuit. Let me draw a circuit. Suppose some information is here, where you have input and you have some output. And let me say this is connected with this, this is connected with this. This is your out one, this is your out two. At time t equal to 1, or you can say t1, the value is 1, 0. Then at time t equal to 2, value is 0, 1. At time t equal to 3, value is 0, 1. Time t equal to 4, value is 0, 1. And so on, it will value will remain 0, 1. Right? Now, what you will say, what value this circuit is storing? Let me say this is your Q and this is your Q bar. So what value Q is storing? Then it is stable. Now the term is stable. Stable means when your value is not changing, then you can say that circuit is a stable circuit. So at the time of stabling this circuit, what value Q stores or Q contain? It is the value zero that Q is containing. Accordingly, if you say this is Q bar, so it is containing one value. Right. So once you say a circuit is stable, it sometimes it is possible that circuit is not stable as t equal to 0 or t equal to 1. Might be at t equal to 2, 3, 4, 5, it is not changing, or then if further it will not change the value, then you can say your circuit is a stable circuit, right? So just keep this in mind. When we say stable means like your output will not change afterward, until there is no change in the input. If your input state will remain same, your output will not change, then you can say your circuit is a stable circuit. But if your output is continuously changing 0 to 1, 1 to 0, 0 to 1, 1 to 0, then you can say your circuit is not stable. But everyone, stable circuit and non-stable circuit. Any doubt on this? Guys, any doubt on this?
No, sir.
Cool. So now let's understand the latch, the very tiny block of the storage. So what we have done, we have taken two NOR gates, right? And we attach them together. Now the beauty here, this output of NOR gate it attach as input here, and this output of NOR gate is attached input here. Now we are saying this is Q and this is Q bar, means these two outputs will be complementary each other. Now here inputs are R and S, reset and set. We'll come into that, what is reset, what is set. This is nothing, this is a specific value we are talking about. So now let me take this circuit and just feed the values. First of all, let us feed the values and then we'll see what is the output, right? So let me draw the circuit here, so that once you feed the value, you will have an idea. Right. So this is feeding here. This is feeding here. And here we have two outputs. Let me say R and S. And this is your Q and this is your Q bar. Getting? Now suppose, let me change the color. Suppose the value of R and S is 0 and 1. Right? You can choose any value of Q in the beginning. So let me choose the value of Q is 1 and value of obviously Q bar is 0. This is the initial value. So let me, instead of writing here, let me write it somewhere. Here, let me initially Q equal to 1 and Q bar equal to 0. Now once Q equal to 1, Q bar equal to 0, okay. In order to make your task much easier, let me draw the table of NOR gate as well. So if you have, let me say A, B and out. So once it is 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1, so what will be the output in case of 0 0?
1 1 0 0 0 0 0 0.
This is your NOR gate. Now let's see. I am saying initially Q is 1. So in that case, here we will get 1 and here you will get 0. Now what will be the value? 0 and 0, you will get value 1. 1 and 1, you will get value 0. Again, if you feed back, your value is 0. And if you feed back, you will get value. Once you feed back here, you will get 0. And once you feed back this value here, you will get 0 here and 1 here. Now, so you can say if your R value is 0 and S value is 1, then we got value 1 and 0. So we said we start with 1 and 0. And then the value will remain 1 and 0. Even if you run it n number of times, it will remain 1 and 0. Got it? Any doubt on this, first of all? Guys, any doubt? How value is 1 and 0 of Q and Q bar? Even if you run multiple times.
Sir, could you explain once again? I got confused.
Okay. So I'm saying initially I started with Q equal to 1 and Q bar equal to 0. This is my assumption, like initial value is 1 and 0. Got it? Now, if it is Q equal to 1, then here we feed 1 as input. And because Q bar is 0, we feed 0 here. Now we have a NOR gate. So 0 and 0, what is the output? It is 1. So you got again 1. And 1 and 1, you will get 0. So you will get 0 here. Now, if you again feed Q and Q bar, 0 and 0, you will get 1. And 1 and 1, you will get 0. Any doubt? So even if you run it multiple times, then also the value will remain 1 and 0. So you can say the value of Q equal to 1 and Q bar equal to 0 is the stable value. Can we see that?
Yes, sir. Always 1, always 0. Yes, sir.
Right. Now, let me take another example. Then you will understand what is the stability mean. So let me erase this entirely. Erase this. Okay. This. Now I'm saying the value, what I'm starting with. So that is, so this is was the first case, and we got your Q equal to 1 and Q bar equal to 0. Then in the second case, initial value, let me say I am started with 0 and 1. Reverse of that. So I am saying Q equal to 0 and Q bar equal to 1. So now what will happen? This 0 will feed here, and this 1 will feed here. Correct? Any doubt till this point?
No, sir.
Now what will happen? This 0 and 1, what it will give as an output?
So 0.
0. And this 0 and 1, what output you will get here?
0.
0. Now again we will feed 0 0. So this will become 0 and this is remain 0. Now 0 0, what you will get?
1.
And 0 1?
0.
0. Now again, if we feed 1 0, so means this will become 1 and this is remain 0. What we'll get? 0 0?
1.
And 0 1 1?
0.
If you again feed the same value, because this is remain same, you will get 1 0. It means
0.
Even you start with 1 0, then also it will become stable and 1 0. Even if you have started with 0 1, then what will happen? First 0 1, it will change to 0 0. And then it will be stable at 1 0. Means now if you run for even 100 times or even 1000 times, it will remain 1 0. Got it? So you can say this is the stable point. So now you reach with the stable point where your Q value equal to 1 and Q bar equal to 0. Got my point? What was the meaning of stable over there? Any doubt, yes, guys?
Sir, but what is this R and S exactly, sir?
Okay, R and S just the input values, you can say. R is reset and S is set. So now let me go back in the truth table. What it mean whenever your R value or S value is 1, then your Q value will also become 1. When your reset value is 1, then your Q value is become 0. That is the meaning of this set and reset. Got it?
Yes.
So this is your set and reset. Now let me take another example. Any doubt till this point, anyone? Guys, any doubt till this point?
No, sir.
Cool. Now let me take another example. So before taking the example, okay, let me erase everything and I'll like make a fresh diagram. So I have a NOR gate, same diagram I'm making. I want new inputs instead of erasing a lot. I choose to make them. Okay. Here we have Q, here we have Q bar, and this was your reset and this was your set. Right. Now I'm saying my reset and set value is 0, 0. I have fixed this to 0, 0. Got it? Now I'm saying I am storing the value of Q is 1 and value of Q bar is 0. This is my storage point. So once I say my value of Q is 1 and value of Q bar is 0. So whenever we will iterate the circuit, the value should be remain same. It should not modify. Right. So let's check is really it will going to modify or not. So once you say 1, 0, so you can say this is the, so this 0 will feed here and this 1 will feed here. So what we'll get, 0 and 0, may I make the NOR table again for quick reference. So now what you'll get, 0 and 0, you'll get 1. And 0 and 1, you'll get 0. Means if you run 10 times, then also you'll get the same value. Got it? It will be remain 1 and 0. Now, what I'm saying instead of storing 1 and 0, what I am storing 0 and 1. So that whenever we are come back, the value of Q will remain 0. So let's check is really it is doing correctly or not. Once you say it is 0, this is 1. So what will happen? 0 and 1, it will be 0, and 0 and 0, it will be 1. So it will remain 0, 1. It means if you store bit 0, then it will be remain 0. If you store value 1, then it will remain 1. So ultimately what we have made a 1-bit storage device, we have 3 options. If you want to reset it, you will make R equal to 1 and S equal to 0. So it will reset. Reset means irrespective of in what position is current, that value of Q and Q bar, it will reach to the Q equal to 0 and Q bar equal to 1. Now, if you say I want a set position. So then what you will do, you will make, so in case of reset, you will set value of R equal to 1 and value of S equal to 0. In case of set, what you will do, you will make this value is 0, this value is 1. And when say I want to act as a memory, means whatever the value of Q, it will remain same, then you will take 0, 0. Got it, everyone? Any doubt till this point? Guys, any doubt till this point? Yes, no.
No, sir.
8. Okay. Now, we have one more input left, that is 1-1. So let's look into this 1-1 as well. What is the story with the 1-1? So first, let me raise this. This and this, this and this. Now suppose I am saying I have value 1 and 1. Let us start with q equal to 0, q bar equal to 1. Then what will happen? This 0 will feed here, this 1 will feed here. What you will get here?
0.
0. What will get here?
0.
Obviously 0. Now, if it is feeding 0, 0, then this will change to the 0. Now, what next output? 1, 0.
0.
And here 1, 0.
0.
0. Means now onward, it will remain 0, 0. But what is my expectation? Our expectation, this Q and it should be Q and Q bar value, which is not meeting here. So in that case, you can say this is undefined state. Whenever your R and S value, you can say 1-1, that particular state is known as undefined state. Because your Q and Q bar value both are become 0-0. That is not acceptable. These should be complement to each other. Getting? So let's summarize it in this table. When it is 1-1, both values are 0-0, that's why it is known as undefined state. When S value is 1, your Q value will become 1 in the stable point. Even if you start with 0-1, then also it will turn out, once it will be stable, it will become 1-0. When your R value is 1, means reset value is 1, then your Q value will become 0. Even you start with 1-0, then also after 2 iterations, it will become 0-1. Once you have 0-0 as input, then it will act as a memory. Got it, everyone? Any doubt till this point? Anyone, any doubt?
No, guys, sir.
Any doubt till this point?
No, sir.
Cool. So now, if you do not have any doubt, let's take another variant of this, that is with the NAND gate. So this is simple code. I'll discuss code later on. But if you want, like you can check out here, we have Q as a output. This is as input, Q bar as a output. This is as input. Similarly, in the, you can say, behavioral diagram, we have taken these two. This is quite simple. Now let's look into the another variant of SR latch. That is the with the NAND gate, right? So let's look into this. So let me give the same. Let's do some exercise with this, with the NAND gate. So they also made in the similar way. And right. So here we have set, here we have reset, and here we have Q, here we have Q bar. Now, if you check out NOR gate, Q is the output of reset, means the gate which is utilized. So you can say here we have reset, here we have Q, here we have set, here we have Q bar. But in case of NAND, it is inverse. Set with Q, reset with Q bar. Sometimes this is also, that's why called as set and reset bar latch. Now you will check why it is the set and reset bar latch. So when you have value 0-0, it will give output as 1-1. And again, this is disallow, or you can say undefined state. Now here, when set value is 0, when your set value is 0, your Q will become 1. When your set value is 1, your Q will become 0. Now this NAND gate is act as a storage when value is 1, 1. Then it will act as a storage or memory. right? This is your SR latch with NAND gate. So let's do some exercise. Then it will be more clear. So first, let me draw the table for this. So it is 00011011. So what will be the output? 00111010. Right. This is NAND gate. Any doubt on this, anyone? How we have drawn this truth
no,
table?
Sir.
Cool. Now let us start with some random input. Suppose I am saying my value of set is 1 and value of reset is 0. And let us start with a random value. Let me say it is 1, it is 0. Now what will happen? We will pick this 1, this will become 0. 1 and 0, what I will get? 1, 0, it will remain 1. And 1, 0 here, this will also remain 1. Now, because this is 1, so this will cancel and this will become 1. 1 and 1, it will become 0. And 1 and 0, it will remain 1. Right? So once this has become 0, this will turn to the 0. 0 and 0, it will remain 1. And 1 and 1, it will remain 0. Now, if you run n number of times, it will remain 0 and 1, 0 and 1, and so on. So, means now your circuit is stable in the value of when Q equal to 0 and Q bar equal to 1, when your value is 1, 0. So, let me write it. S and R, this is 1, this is 0. So your Q is stable with the 0 value and Q bar is stable with the 1 value. Now, suppose we have value 0, 1 of SR. Okay, so let me take another value. So initially start okay, 0 and 1. So again, I'm starting with 1, 0. So this will be 1, this will be 0. 0, 0, it will be 1, and 1, 1, it will be 0. So now even if you run n number of times, then also it will remain 1, 0. Right? If you want, you can start with reverse input, then also it will become stable in 1, 0. That we already seen it, right? So once it is 0, 1, you will get value 1 and 0. Now let me take value 1, 1. So this I want 1. Let me take the value of 1, 1. Right? Suppose initially we have value 0, 1. So I'm taking value 1, 1. And initially I'm saying value is 0, 1. So now this will be 0, this will be 1, 1 and 1, you will get 0, 0 and 1, you will get 1. 1 and 1, you will get 0, 0 and 1, you will get 1. Right? So it will remain same. So means if you start with 0, 1, it will remain 0, 1. Now let me start with 1, 0. So let me start with 1, 0. Now this is 1 and this is 0. So 1 and 0, it will be 1. 1 and 1, it will be 0. Right? It will be remain 1, 0 and so on. So means if we start with 1, 0, it will remain 1, 0. If you start with 0, 1, it will remain 1, 0, 1. Means this 1, 1 input act as a memory cell. Whatever you stored, if you stored 0 on Q, it will remain 0. Whenever you want to retrieve, or you can say whenever you will retrieve the value, you will get only 0 value. Even after 10 minutes, even after 20 minutes, the value will remain same. If you are storing 1, 0, and when you retrieve it 10 minutes back, you will take, whenever you retrieve the value, you will remain with the 1, 0 value. Or you can say Q value is 1. So then it will act as a memory cell. Now, there is a last input that is 00. Once you will pass 00, This is also 0. This is also 0. So 0 and 1. So let me erase so that. So once we say we have value 0, 0 here, and we start with 1, 0. So we'll get 1 here, 0 here. So 0 and 0, what you'll get? 1. And 1 and 0, what you'll get? 1. And you can see Q. Okay, let me run it again. So this will be 1. 0 and 1, you'll get 1. 0 and 1, you'll get 1. So even after a longer time, then also you'll get 1, 1 value. And with the concept, it is not valid. 1 should be 0, another should be bar of that. So means you can say this is undefined state. Work it, everyone. So this is your latch with the help of NAND gate. Any doubt on this till now? Guys, any doubt on this? NAND gate. So you can say SR latch with the NAND gate. Anyone, any doubt till this point? Guys, any doubt till this point?
No, sir.
Cool. Okay. So this is the summary of the entire SR latch. You can say with the NOR gate. So this is your set state. This is your reset state. And this is your undefined state. And once value is 0, 0, this will act as a memory state. In case of NAND gate, whenever value is 1, 1, this will act as a memory state, right? Whenever set value is 1, it will be reset state. Whenever set value is 0, it will be set state. That's why this NAND gate latch is also known as S bar R bar latch sometimes. So once you say S bar R bar latch, means you're talking about the NAND gate latch, SR latch with NAND gate. Got it? Any doubt, guys? Anyone? Guys, any doubt?
No, sir.
Now, in this circuit, there is one big problem. What is that big problem? This circuit is not synchronous circuit. Means, suppose we have 10 such elements or 100 such elements in the circuit. Now, if your wire, let me say, if your wire is longer and another circuit or another component connect with the shorter wire. So this is longer wire. Let me say this is the start and this is the end, because all wires will not be same length. If you have a PCB board, let me say you have PCB board. Suppose one part is here, another part is here, another part is here, and so on. And if you want to connect them, it is not always true you will get the same length wire to connect them together. Means there is a big possibility that wires have different length, right? So in that case, in short, what will happen if we do not have any control mechanism, right? Till this moment, we do not have any control mechanism. Once reset will get value, it will operate and it will modify the Q value, right? Once set will get value, it will operate, it will modify the Q value. So here you do not have any control mechanism. When this circuit will operate, when, or you can say when this value will be modified. So we always want the entire circuit will operate in a synchronous manner. It should not happen one part of the circuit run first, then second part of the circuit run second, or you don't know when first will run, when second will run. You do not have any control on that. Then it's a big problem, right? In order to control the circuit, we have added a clock over there, right? So now you can say the utility of clock. Now you can say, suppose our lectures, let me give a very simple example. Suppose our lectures, I'm saying there is no timing of the lecture. There is no fixed timing. There is no clock involved in the lecture. Can we take the lecture?
No, sir.
It will be very difficult. Might be when when I thought, okay, let me take the lecture any time in the day, I will switch on and start lecturing. Maybe only two are able to ready to take the lecture, or maybe few of them is ready to take. When you thought, okay, let me attend the lecture, might be at that time lecture is not going. So it means everything is sync with the time, and the time is going with the clock. Ultimately, the clock is syncing to everything. Same thing happened in the circuit as well. Whenever we operate with the circuit, it is synced with the time. It is synced with the clock. So we should have a control mechanism. When we say clock value is high, then only you will operate the circuit. Or you can say then only you will modify this Q value. Even if you receive a value in R and S, that will not able to modify this Q value. Even if you receive in advance. When you want to modify, whenever you are ready to modify, so that your entire circuit will be synced, right? So let's understand how exactly happen. So you can say clock is always with the period of time, right? So here one period, second period, and so on, you have a clock. There is another way to control the circuit, right? Now one another way is controlling this circuit so that you have a control on Q. When your clock timing is very less, when it will operate, and it should be lesser than the time of the NOR gate. How much time? Suppose your NOR gate is taking 1 nanosecond, then your clock should be lesser than 1 nanosecond. Then only you can control it. But that is not possible. Because maybe this is taking different time, this is taking different time, this AND NAND gate is taking different time, and you have multiple such inputs in available. So you have to check like which time we have to sync. So that is a big challenge. So now to solve this challenge, we are using the clock circuit. Right? This is the clock circuit. So I'll come into that when your clock is smaller, when clock is bigger, what problem will come into the picture. So now what I'm saying, when we have a clock circuit, I'm saying, so let's understand this clock, how this clock is look like. So in this clock, you have three important part. First part is this. Second part is this. Third part is this. And let me say fourth part is this. We have four different parts of this clock. Then it will start repeating from here again, same values. This is when you say this part of the clock, this is says as rising edge. Right? When you say this part of the clock, this is your falling edge. Right? When you say this part of the clock, this is your, you can say high value. Value is high. And once you say this part of the clock, value is low. So now this entire clock is based on these four components. One is the rising edge. Second is the falling edge. Third is the high value. And fourth is the low value. These are four major part of the clock. Right? Now I'm saying, like I want to make a circuit that is just storage and the control in our hand. When I will say my clock is high, then on low, then only your circuit output will be modified. Once we say clock is low, then circuit will not modify, right? That kind of control we want, right? So I think in the next lecture, because we do not have sufficient time to complete it, so in the next lecture, we'll see how we will able to control the modification in the Q and Q bar value based on the clock. When you say clock is high, then only the value will be modified. When you say clock is low, then value will not modify. Right? So we'll see all in the next lecture. Right? Any doubt till this point, anyone? Guys, any doubt till this point? We have gone through SR latch with NOR gate. We have gone through SR latch with NAND gate, and we talk about the clock. What are the different phase of clock? And we'll see once we have a larger system, they are connected with same clock, so that you can sync them together, right? So we'll see how we can involve the clock into the latch, and we'll see how to solve the problem of undefined state as well, when it acts as a storage. Any doubt, guys? Anyone till this point?
No, sir.
Nice. So we'll catch you in the next lecture on Saturday, and then we'll discuss further. So in this Saturday, I have to check. I'll go with the lecture, or I will go with the YouTube video, because Wednesday is the additional day. Previously Wednesday was the off, so that's why previous Wednesday was fine. But this next Saturday, Wednesday is extra day, so I have to check out. Okay, guys, thank you. So we'll catch you in the next lecture, most probably on Wednesday. Most probably on Monday.
Yes. The lectures on LMS, sir.
Yeah, I will do.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Yeah. And so the Viva will be after midsend, right?
No, I will discuss in this week. Once we have faculty meeting, then I will let you know in the next week lecture, in the Monday.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Okay, guys. We'll catch you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you, sir.